very good morning and welcome to Adhavan Newspaper Highlights. Today, Friday, 17th of March 2017. This is Edward with the highlights of today's English newspapers. As usual, we have three leading daily newspapers for the highlights. Daily Mirror, Daily News and Ceylon Today. Firstly, let's have a brief look on the Daily Mirror. The main headline highlights, Sri Lanka to co-sponsor resolution again. Government had requested for an extension of 2 years to implement it. Content was the national program provided by Sri Lanka government. Foreign judges just a recommendation by international community, stating that the resolution that is once more to be co-sponsored by Sri Lanka at the UNHRC is the resolution that was presented previously in 2015. Foreign Minister Mangala Samaravira stated the government had requested for an extension of 2 years to implement the resolution. President ponders withdrawing fisheries portfolio from Amaravira. The third one is Provincial Fisheries Minister. All are from the same electorate. President Maithripala Sirisena said yesterday he would consider changing the fisheries portfolio from Minister Mahinda Amaravira so that he could be given different responsibilities to handle development work in the Hambantota district. Sri Lanka captain of hijacked ship says, firing puts our lives at risk. Requests Sri Lanka to ask Somali authorities to cease firing at the tanker. Says all 8 crew members are safe. Mangala Harsha spoke to Sri Lanka crew. S.A. Nicholas, the captain of the oil tanker that was hijacked by the Somali pirates, told Daily Mirror yesterday evening that their lives were at risk because of the presence of Somalian Coast Guard boats in the vicinity. Mahindran transferred 500 Central Bank staff in 2015. When Arjuna Mahindran was the governor of the Central Bank, he had transferred 500 members of the bank's staff, including some senior officers and heads of departments in year 2015 alone. Assistant Governor and the Secretary of the Monetary Board of the Central Bank, H.A. Karunaratne, told the Presidential Commission of Inquiry to investigate and inquire into the issuance of treasury bonds yesterday that it was the first time in the bank's history that so many transfers had been made within 1 year. Secondly, let's move to Daily News. The main headline of the Daily News says, Somalian authorities tell Sri Lanka hopeful of quick release of Aries 13 crew. Foreign agencies report exchange of fire between Somali forces pirates. We have already had a look deeply in that news on Daily Mirror. Anura Senanayake requests CID to arrest real killers of Tajuddin. Making a startling statement in court, former DIG Anura Senanayake, who is in remand custody over an investigation pertaining to the murder of former rugby player Wasim Tajuddin, yesterday requested CID to arrest the real killers who were involved in the murder of Wasim Tajuddin through a comprehensive investigation. Kenya Trinco government hospitals full of dengue patients. With fresh dengue cases being reported every day, government hospitals in Kenya and Trincomalee are finding it difficult to keep up with the rush of patients due to inadequate infrastructure. Dengue eradication should be a collective responsibility, Professor Vitarana. The government should intervene to prevent and control the spread of dengue with the assistance of entomologists, Lanka Samasamaja Party General Secretary Professor Thissa Vidharana said. The eradication of dengue should be a collective responsibility of the government as well as that of the general public. Finally, let's move to Ceylon Today. The main headline of the Ceylon Today highlights, inviting support of like-minded UN members, US backs 2 year extension for Sri Lanka. The Trump government says it has worked in close consultation with the UK, Montenegro, Macedonia and Sri Lanka, which co-sponsored the UN resolution and is looking forward to the adoption of the new draft that will be tabled on March 22, 2017. The US invites like-minded UNHRC member countries to support the new resolution to support Sri Lanka, whose government earlier this week urged the UN Human Rights Council core group to give Sri Lanka a 24-month extension to work on the US-sponsored resolution that awaits a favorable response from the UN body. Nurachole call racket allegations. Joe demands a fraud probe. The joint opposition yesterday lodged a complaint with the bribery commission, alleging that Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe, Minister Malik Samara Wickrema, PM's advisor R. Bhaskaran Lingam and Charitha Ratwatta had caused a loss of 5,000 million rupees in connection with the supply of coal to the Nuracholai coal power plant and demanded a probe into the process of the loss. The allegation was handed over to the bribery commission by Joe and SLFP Kalutara District MP Vidura Wickremanayake. Queen signs Brexit into law. The Queen has given royal assent to the Brexit bill, clearing the way for Theresa May to start talks to leave the European Union. The European Union bill was passed by MPs and peers on Monday. It allows the Prime Minister to notify Brussels that the UK is leaving the EU with a two-year process of exit negotiations to follow. With that, let's come to the end of today's paper highlight. We will come with more news tomorrow morning. Thanks for listening to Adhavan Newspaper Highlights.